I have two dogs that previously fought, found solid canine, implemented tons of structure and muzzle conditioning. They are now able to exist.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much for all of the free content.
Who's that? Coach?
Coach Harden.
Coach Harden, proud of you. Proud of your
hard work. A lot of work doing that rehab on your own. Good for you.
Yes, proud of all your hard work. I'm proud of all of you. Mm-hmm. All of you that are doing all this stuff. I cannot tell you how many people have rehabbed their dogs with our free content.
I know.
But that's just code word for they did all the work.
Yeah.
Because information is not what is the most important part. Mm-hmm. Everybody's got access to the same information. It's the implementation of that information, which is the hard work. That's why we put up free content. Because it's like, you know, why do you put up so much free content? Why? Because there's a lot of lazy fucking people out there. They're still not going to do it. All right? But it's for the people out there that are either they cannot economically afford us or geographically get to us. And right now, it's really hard to geographically get to us.
Sure is.
You know, so that's why we're coming up with some more virtual stuff. But we're still getting dogs coming in. Still getting dogs coming in. So we're still open for business.
Still here.
Still can book your boarding trains. So next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Yeah! Gellman Seminars canine training with a What Would Jeff Do show with Joelle.
Hello.
Some news to announce. We are fixing the camera's crookedness. Other than that, our show is going to be now a Monday, Wednesday, and instead of Saturday night, starting next week, it's going to be Friday night. So Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we're going to make it really easy, and it's a one-hour show, 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. We've got a lot of new projects that we're working on, Joelle is working on, I'm working on, so we're going to be doing that. We're going to be starting on the solid canine training part. We're going to be starting doing Zooms in our Patreon channel.
Woohoo!
So you want to be joining Patreon because
that's
there's going to be some
cool.
Really
what are
great
you doing
stuff.
Zooms for?
I'm going to be doing Zooms during the day, not at night. During the day on training, it'll be more in depth because you know how a lot of people when I'm like they're like, how do I stop this? And I'm like, there's too many variables.
Way too many variables.
Now yeah. I can be like, we can talk, we can do variables. So almost like a mini Skype, but it's cool. But it's only gonna get you like 5 minutes. But I'm just saying though, is like it's a lot more variables there because I want to be able to help as many people as possible, and that's gonna be on the Patreon channel.
Cool.
And then we'll be able to we're gonna be announcing some big things for Joelle that she's gonna be doing, and we'll probably announce that in the next couple of weeks. As well, and I'm going to help her push all that because she's been such a big supporter, obviously, of us and continue to be a supporter of us as well. But everyone's being creative right now. Everyone's being creative. This is a good example of like how creative, you know, we all can be. Bam. Okay, here we go. So what would Jeff do? Well, what concept is this? Concept, proven concept. 15 years of proven concepts here. You ask a question, we give you an answer. Most of the answers work wide paintbrush stroke with most dogs. There's always going to be some variables, though. There's dogs here that even the advice that I'm about to give you, I'm like, well, that wouldn't work with that dog. We'd have to work, you know, we'd have to do some variables. But most stuff, though, put it this way, people are watching our free content and fully training their dogs. So there is going to be some troubleshooting on some of your stuff. Also, I'm not getting enough information from you, which is one of the reasons why I want to do this Zoom room. So it's like we can actually talk.
Zoom room. Is that really what it's called?
Well, it's Zoom is the platform and you're in a room. So I guess it's called Zoom room. All right. All right. Okay. Here we go. There's something called Top Chat. Now that we're only doing an hour show, we're going to try to get through all the questions. There's something called Top Chat. It's a dollar sign down at the bottom. What you do is you click on that. Your question goes right to the top of the queue. And we read it right away, but you do not have to pay to play. As you will see, we try to go through as many questions as possible. Also, you're going to hear me talk about punishment a lot. Remember, punishment is not abuse. That's been hijacked by a lot of different people. It's just like reward. It's reward. It's punishment. Call it a correction. Call it whatever you want to. It's a motivator. And the only way to stop an unwanted behavior, which is what most people are going to be asking on this show, how do I stop, how do I stop, how do I stop, is through a punisher. You cannot stop an unwanted behavior through a reward. We do tons of reward-based training. We clicker train every single dog that walks in here. We use markers. We use food. So hope everyone's staying healthy. Everyone's doing okay. And listen, if you're not, this is going to be going on for a while. Mm-hmm. Reframe shit. Got it? Reframe shit. Reframe it. Let's go.
Let's go. Melissa said good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone in the chat.
No, thank you, Melissa.
Denicia said hello, everyone.
Hey, Denicia.
Diana, hello all from Tennessee. Stay safe.
What's up, TN? Everybody that's listening on the podcast also. Everybody on, oh my God, I know we're on 20 different podcasts. And we got Spotify, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Apple, Google, everything. Hello, all. How are you?
Jenny, hi. I hope you guys are staying safe.
Yes, we are. Yep. We're all technically, I don't want to say quarantine, but we're pretty much, I'm living at the center now, so because I'm out and about, so I don't go home. My family is like literally locked and loaded at home. Everything is delivered. They don't leave the house. I'm sleeping here. We've got three other staff members that stay here. So we don't really have a lot of the public here. Like we had one person, a couple in, drop off a dog for a boarding train here. And it's just like, we rarely see people. It's a pretty much closed down facility. Mm-hmm. So it's extremely safe. And we've got really good safety protocols on the handoffs. Like we use our own leashes. We use our own equipment. We wipe all the collars down.
I saw everything.
Yeah, well, I saw the hell out of everything. Anyway, next question.
Melissa said, great content going up regularly on Jeff's Patreon.
That's right.
Posted the link.
Yep. Great content on our regular page, Instagram, Facebook, Patreon, a lot of great stuff. YouTube, a lot of great stuff. Helpful stuff. Very helpful. Next.
Sophia, hey guys, happy Saturday.
Happy Saturday to
is
you.
Is that the day? I don't even know anymore.
It is Saturday. Tomorrow's Sunday. Hmm. Yep.
Blessing. So here's how I've been handling the whining in the crate. I will ignore her for the most part, but if she gets crazy, then I will go bonk her. And anytime she is calm, I calmly praise her and maybe throw a piece of kibble in there. I have seen some improvements, but do you have any other tips?
I wouldn't. Okay. So we reward good behavior, but be careful. Okay. Put it this way. If it's working, keep doing it. We don't throw kibble in for being quiet. We just don't correct. So the lack of a correction is the reward.
I think this is a younger dog, though, like real young puppy.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's their new puppy.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. But just be careful in general about that concept. Just be careful about that concept because eventually the dog trains the human. Next.
Cheryl, hi, Jeff and Joelle. Joelle, your hair looks great. Thanks, Cheryl. Loving your Instagram videos. How are you both and everyone else is doing well? Hope you both and everyone else is doing well.
Yeah,
that makes more sense.
Yeah, we're working our asses off. You know, I've mentioned this many times in business. We've had to cut our staff. Our business, like every other business, has been affected like this. We are considered a vital business. We take care of living things. We've got dogs that are here that need to be taken care of 24/7, and we're an essential business in the state of Rhode Island, and I think in most states animal care is.
Yeah.
We have people that work full time that need their dogs taken care of during the day. Obviously nobody's traveling now, so boarding business is down, but there are people though that are that, you know, they want the dog out of the house. So there's all kinds of different things, all kinds of different things, but we're doing okay. You know, just like most of you probably, we're going up it. You know, it's an emotional roller coaster. I think we're all on an emotional roller coaster. So you need to start reframing that. Once it starts getting warmer outside here in Providence, things will be dramatically better. I mean, the fucking sun came out today for the first time in a long time.
Grab dog, go for dogs.
I mean, it was still 52, but the sun was out. Yeah. So once it gets into the 60s and sunny and then 70s and sunny, it's like shit's going to get real fun. In fact, we'll set the pool up. Mm-hmm. So here we go. Next.
Jenny, I have a question about some minor stranger fear. My dog often whines when and if we stop to talk to someone on walks.
Yes.
Even if there is space, he gets a bit nervous. He's a Belgian Malinois Argentino Dogo.
Okay. So you got yourself a dog that knows how to bite and will bite. So, well, all dogs will bite. So what I want you to do is this. You can correct that. You can correct nervousness. A lot of people say, oh, don't do that. The dog will be more afraid of strangers. No, 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 no. You told me what was wrong. I'm telling you how to fix it. We're not creating stuff. We're fixing stuff. So A remote collar on a lower level probably would be like, hey, pretty much just cut the shit, mind your business, and advocate for the dog. Don't let the stranger or the person try to pet the dog. If the dog backs up a little bit, allow it to. Next.
Brother Daggett, my dog keeps running after and chasing people that are running near our house. What should I do about it?
Number one, don't let your dog off leash outside unsupervised. Your dog's going to end up dead. Because if your dog chases me down the street, it won't end up good. And I'm a nonviolent person. But the hell if I'm going to let some dog bite my ass, because it's happened before. Okay? So, number one, dog should be on a long line. Number two, fence in your property. Number three, teach your dog an incredible recall. But I wouldn't let your dog off leash. It's a liability. It is a liability. Yeah. Next.
Sophia, I finally got my e-collar yesterday. When conditioning with e-collar, I've been dialing up a couple digits when Bruno gets distracted. Is that okay, or should I only be using leash guidance for conditioning?
No, leash guidance won't condition the e-collar. The e-collar being used will condition it. What are you conditioning it for? What are you doing with it? Are you teaching obedience, or are you fixing a behavior problem? Next.
Rick, hi, J&J. Just wanted to jump in and say hello. Wishing you the best, Rick and Trapper.
Oh, Rick and Trapper. Hey, how are you? Thanks. Thanks for jumping in and saying hello. Really appreciate it. Next. Yep.
Eric, hey, guys. I currently feed my dog instant kibble. While I know this kibble is one of the better ones, I want to start adding raw. However, I read today that adding raw to kibble invites problems because two foods digest at different rates. Any truth to this? Thanks.
What I would do is this. As far as nutrition is concerned and medical is concerned, don't ask dog trainers. I'm a dog trainer. I'm a family pet dog trainer. So don't ask me sport dog stuff either. Or working dog stuff, except for public access. So what I would do is this, and I'm not trying to sell you anything. You go on to SallyCanineTraining.com/shop. We've got an introduction to feeding raw ebook. Download it. It'll answer all your questions. Next.
David, hi J&J, hope all is well. What are some safety protocols that you implement in your daycare that might set you apart from others? I've seen quite a few sketchy practices in kennels I've worked.
What do? We know the dog, we know the limits, we understand pressure, we stop anything before it starts, we run the show, all dogs are underneath our care, we advocate for every single dog, every dog will be corrected for doing something inappropriate. We don't put unsafe dogs with safe dogs out there. We have different socials. We don't let dogs get, we do have fun playtime for safe dogs. And then if it's a dog that we're rehabbing, we'll let them go get a little bit excited, but we'll use our dogs for that. A lot of times they're muzzled up. We're a rehab center. We're not a daycare. So it's a little bit different. So we have massive safety protocols.
I think the biggest thing is just structure. Like, our daycare is so structured.
Everything is structured. Everything is structured. Every single thing. How you walk out the door. How you behave outside. How you walk in the door. How you come out of your kennel. How you go back into your kennel. Everything is structured. Mm-hmm. Every little thing is structured. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, good evening, Michelle. Is that Michelle P?
Michelle Anderson.
Oh, Michelle Anderson, Calgary. Hey, how are you?
Jenny, dog is doing great with training, but sometimes when I give him certain commands, he gets talkative and talks back even as he does the command.
Yeah.
How do you reward the right behavior but stop the talking back?
Tell him to shut the fuck up and reward him. So, you know, you just might have a grumbler. You can correct that. You can correct that. So if you want to speed that up, you know, chances are while he's talking back to you, he might be also not going as quick as he could. So... And also, if the dog is done enough reps, you can stop rewarding. So we use a reward-based training system to teach all of our obedience 300 to 500 times before we tell the dog no. So I don't know how many reps you've already done. But if you've put your reps in and that dog is grumbling, you can correct. Next.
Morgan, both my dogs are off-leash trained, and I take them to play chuck it at the park. One dog has high toy drive and plays fetch. The other just chases her and tries to play as she runs.
Yes.
The toy-driven dog growls and air snaps at her. Okay. How do I correct it, as it only happens when she's running in high drive? Mm-hmm. Outside of this, they have no resource guarding. Snaps have never escalated.
Leave it alone. Leave it alone. That's what dogs are doing. If it's never escalated, leave it alone. And if it's your two dogs, leave it alone. So, your two dogs... You know your dogs. It's never escalated. It's in drive. It's only in this situation. Leave it alone. That's how they play. That's their play style. Next.
Jamie, any suggestions for crazy huskies? I'm going insane.
Tons of suggestions. Define crazy. What are you trying to stop? Yeah, watch my videos. Start watching my videos. Do it yourself 2020 series. Teach your dog place. Put in structure. Have a massive routine. Husky or non-husky doesn't make a difference. A dog is a dog. Yes, there are some different nuances in dogs. I get it. I work with plenty of huskies. Yes, a husky can be walked in a perfect off-leash heel. Yes, a husky can have great recall. Yes, a husky doesn't need to pull. Yes, you can have an on-off switch for a husky. But what's the structure? What are you looking to do? But why, start with my do-it-yourself videos. If you've not gone down the rabbit hole and trained at least a two-hour place, you have not even started then. Next.
Barista boy, just saw the video on Instagram of Lily. Love that dog. Pretty drivey, too.
Yeah, she's very, very drivey. I love Lily. And she'll be staying here for an extra week. We have a lot of dogs staying here for extra time. Their owners actually can't get them because we do a lot of business with New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, Maryland. So dogs are staying here for a little bit longer, and they'll be they're still going to be trained. But you still got to work them. I got incredible staff here. Staff's doing great. Kristen, who runs the kennel and the boarding, that slowed down, so she's painting. So she's painting.
We're just doing more with the dogs. Like Lily, she's like finished. She's ready to go home. But now we're like, let's teach you rollover. Yeah, we're doing like trick training with her now. Yeah,
we're just doing great stuff. And it's good to have good solid dogs, and it's good to have finished dogs here too. Yeah. And we're keeping them busy because we're not going to let them regress. We're not going to let them regress next.
Blessing, yes, she will sometimes get a bit excited, even if I don't give food, even if I just say good.
Yeah, so what you want to do is, if it's a young puppy, that's fine. Next.
Jay, hey, Jay, thanks for putting out all the great content.
Every day. Next.
Tiffany, hi, love you guys so much, so helpful. So I have a Sharpei, 5 months, with very high prey drive, just wants to play with kitties, but too big and rough, and cats still adjusting, too scared. Been leash training... where's the rest? It says 1 out of 2.
Mm-hmm.
Using chain to pop, correct, but very stubborn and just isn't getting hint to not chase.
Okay.
Recently got an e-collar for more training, but hesitant to dial up since young. Just not sure how to get through on this.
So number one, if you're using a choke chain, switch over to a prong collar. There's a humongous difference. You can also say no and bonk the dog for pestering the cat. Next.
PM, hey guys, where can I find some training on separation anxiety?
I've got a video on, actually we're filming a new video on separation anxiety, but I've got an existing video which still works. Type in separation anxiety, spell it properly, in my search box. It's the one from 2013, but we're making another one tomorrow, which will go up this week. A little bit more content to it, but we talk a lot about separation anxiety here. Yep. Next.
Melissa posted the link to the raw feeding ebook.
Thank you.
Madison, hey guys, I just moved back in with my parents and I've had a difficult time getting our dogs used to each other. My dog just ignores her, but every time my dog walks by, she growls. We correct it, but do you guys have any other tips?
Yeah, your dog, you know, what I would do is get them to exist with each other. Don't have them try to be best friends or playmates right now. Work on existence. It's a change for everybody. A lot of people are stressed right now. Humans are stressed. Dogs are stressed. They're not getting out as much. Now's a good time to work on all your reps. You know, get up their training. Now's a good time to have highly structured routine. If you don't have highly structured routine, you'd be surprised by doing just routine. Like we had a dog come in today, and the first thing Joelle did with this dog was, you're going to learn how to go in and out of your crate properly. Because this dog will drag you down the street. So that's it. You're going in and out of your crate properly. So you did what? 20 reps, 25 reps of kennel up, break, kennel up, break, kennel up, break. And this dog is going to be, and it fights with its litter mate, not litter mate. It fights with its housemate. Mm-hmm. It fights with its housemate, and its housemate is here. So, in fact, on the intake video, if it goes up, you'll hear some whining in the background. That's because it heard its owners talk, but it didn't come out to see its owners, and there was only two of us here, and it was, so that should be interesting. So we have two dogs that fight with each other from the same household.
A lot of fights.
A lot of damage. Yeah. Next.
Coach Harden, I have two dogs that previously fought, found solid canine, implemented tons of structure and muzzle conditioning. They are now able to exist.
Beautiful.
Thank you so much for all of the free content.
Who's that? Coach?
Coach Harden.
Coach Harden, proud of you. proud of your
hard work. A lot of work doing that rehab on your own. Good for you.
Proud of all your hard work. I'm proud of all of you. Mm-hmm. All of you that are doing all this stuff. I cannot tell you how many people have rehabbed their dogs with our free content.
I know.
But that's just code word for they did all the work.
Yeah.
Because information is not what is the most important part. Mm-hmm. Everybody's got access to the same information. It's the implementation of that information, which is the hard work. That's why we put up free content. Because it's like, you know, why do you put up so much free content? Why? Because there's a lot of lazy fucking people out there. They're still not going to do it. All right? But it's for the people out there that are either they cannot economically afford us or geographically get to us. And right now, it's really hard to geographically get to us.
Sure is.
You know, so that's why we're coming up with some more virtual stuff. But we're still getting dogs coming in. So we're still open for business. Still can book your boarding trains. So next.
Karen, have been doing my driveway drills with my Husky for about a week. When should I start incorporating the word heel?
You're probably going to do it now. You tell me, how's the dog doing? And you can probably get out to the street and go one or two houses down each way. Still do all your quick turns. So do your driveway drills in the street now. Couple houses that way, couple houses that this way. That's if you live in farmland and there's 5 acres in between houses. Well, don't do that.
Just 20 more minutes.
That's right. We're almost getting. I got it. Hey, I'll be back tonight. Why'd you get home at 3 a.m? Jeff said do two houses down.
Two houses. They live in like freaking
nowhere.
Yeah.
Texas.
Yeah.
Next.
Tiffany, I already read that. Brother Daggett, hey Jeff, thanks for the info.
Well, you're welcome, Brother Daggett.
Oh my gosh, this name, I don't know how to say it.
That's okay.
Dark eyes? Is that what it's supposed to be? Dark eyes? I have two dachshunds, plenty of activity and attention, but when let outside, I've not been able to break them from racing to the fence to invite the neighbor dogs to bark, and it gets insane.
Right, okay, so I don't...
Fence fighting.
Okay, fence fighting. I don't care how much activity and affection they get. Activity and affection doesn't stop fence fighting. Never has, never will. Never has, never will. Affection's got nothing to do with fence fighting. Activity's got nothing to do with fence fighting. You know what has to do with fence fighting? Is fence fighting. Get yourself remote collars. You get a two-dog remote collar. Okay, get the 302 Micro Educator. Get it on Amazon. Or any two-dog collar from either Dogtra or... e-collar technology. E-collar technology is shut down right now, but Amazon might have still be shipping them, or one of the warehouses like Learburg or Ray Allen or something like that might have them. We're out of them right now. We're holding on to every e-collar we can find right now. So we actually pulled them off of our website because we don't want to ship any of those right now. And this is how you stop fence fighting. One dog at a time. Put one dog out, let it fence fight, make it suck. That's how you stop it. You make fence fighting suck. They suck. Do one dog at a time so it understands what the correction is and they don't end up into a fight. Next.
Coach Harden, also first live. So happy to be here.
Awesome. Great. Thank you for being here.
Lokahai. Hi, J&J. Hope you're doing well. How do you stop whining in the kennel? I give him an e-collar correction, but he just continues to whine.
We talk about whining a lot. Whining, there are so many variables and there's an art to it. So on a remote collar... you can go, people will say, do I go high? Do I go low? Do I hit momentary? Do I hit continuous? I go, yes. That's the answer to that. Try different things. You can open up the kennel door. Dog tries to come out, slam the kennel door. You can do kennel drills. You can do, be more demanding outside of the crate. What happens outside of the crate? Are you holding your dog accountable outside of the crate, or is everything just all fun? And I'm not talking about like the dog waits for the food and makes eye contact and you walk out of the door first. I'm talking about on everything. How structured is your house? How structured is your routine? Now that's not going to in itself eliminate whining, but it's going to help. But there are some dogs out there that are on the fringes that freaking just won't shut the hell up. So try different things. Try a squirt bottle if you want to. Next.
Sophia, by conditioning, I meant I'm teaching what e-collar pressure is, doing that with recall work. Sometimes he'll be distracted, sniffing the air, and doesn't respond to pressure. Dial up some or leash guidance?
You both. Dial up with leash guidance because the remote collar is not directional. I would also do place as one of your first commands as well. Next.
Jay, I was outside this week and saw a stray, loose dog near my house barking. As I approached, he would trot away. I could see that he chewed through his nylon leash and wire tie-out. What would Jeff do?
Nothing. As long as it didn't attack my dog, I'd leave it alone. I'm not going to chase this dog down. So I'm not going to chase it down. You know, so what would I do? I would be like, it'll find its way home. You know, if it had visible dog tags on it. I mean, right now, things that could call up animal control. I did a minimum call up animal control probably, but I wouldn't approach it. I'm not interested at this stage of my life in approaching off-leash dogs. You know? So, not at all. Next.
Not one little bit. Blessing. Dakota will play with the puppy. They have different playing styles, but they make it work. However, he sometimes corrects her for rude behavior, and all he does is just bark in her face. But should I correct that, or is that just communication?
No, that's communication. That's what dogs do. Next.
Morgan, thank you. That's what I was thinking. It's kind of funny how they play when she pounces all over her despite her growling. Haha, have a great weekend.
Yeah, my dogs play fight. If I have videos of my dogs and still photos of girl and Kira, and I'll look for some and I'll put some up. Oh, shoot, they're on the hard drive that's in my house.
What?
Videos of them, photos of them playing. I've got a series of photos. You know that long lens that we have that we never use?
Yeah.
I used that lens when I was over at Eric's place in Ohio, and I took some incredible photos of them like play fighting, and people, it looks like real fights.
Oh, yeah.
People would be like, oh my God, they're like fighting. I'm like, no, they're just playing. Yeah. They're just playing. Next.
Girl does that to Wes when he plays Chuck It. She just chases Wes. Yep. She doesn't give a shit about the ball.
Yep. Next.
Jenny, thanks for all the amazing info. Can you explain the muzzle punch? Can't find much information on this behavior. Is it as bad as a growl? Thank you so much for your content. We've learned a lot.
The two separate things. The muzzle punch is exactly what it sounds like. The dog takes its muzzle and punches it into you. So the dog's snout punches it, literally
rude behavior.
Punches into you. It's usually pushy, snotty behavior. Or if it's a biting dog, it would have been a bite, but the dog had a muzzle on, so the dog ends up muzzle punching you. That's what a muzzle punch is. Next. You're not punching the dog's muzzle. The dog is taking its muzzle and punching you. Next.
Michelle Anderson, love your couch chat sessions. The last one was excellent explanation of the why behind the markers and training steps. Thank you so much.
Yep, every week there'll be a new one. Next.
Jamie, I've been watching your videos and today purchased a Herm Springer prong collar. I'm hoping this will help in our walks.
If you're not using one, it'll help dramatically. Yep.
Hannah, shalom, y'all. Since you are still training dogs during crazy times, are you accepting new dogs? I'm in South Carolina. I would love to bring you Ziva and Yoda.
Yes. Yeah, we're still accepting new dogs. Fill out an application. Right now, we actually have got about a six-week wait list. Logistically, though, it's harder to get dogs to us now. Mm-hmm. The states have lockdowns. So logistically, it's harder to get dogs to us.
Yeah, but hopefully in 6 to 8 weeks.
Yeah, things will clear up. Things will clear up. Yeah, but
yeah, fill out a form.
Fill out a form. We'll talk on the phone. Next.
Dark eyes. Yes, dark eyes. Okay, good. Glad I got it right. Hannah.
Oh, nice. What was it? Like all one word?
Because they spelled it Q-U-D-A-R-Q.
Oh, I see. I see.
Dark ways. Okay. Like, I'm over here like.
It's the French version of it. Dark ways.
Like, that's not my mindset.
Right,
like,
right. Well, you know what? At least your mind didn't go daiquiris.
True. Hey, it almost looks like
that's
it.
That's right. It's like daiquiris.
Hannah, leash reactive GSD, got the lunging and barking to stop with a prong, but she still shakes with excitement, whines uncontrollably, and stares hard when she sees a dog. We do driveway drills every day. I've tried hard leash pops, successive leash pops, and 180s with no results. Any other suggestions?
Yeah, tons of suggestions. Number one, do look up 180, the 180 move. My 180 move was not my original 180 move. It's based on the Keeler method of dog training, a little bit modified method of that I use. Also, a remote collar is going to be your best friend. Also, you can use the bonker at the first sign of loading. Your dog is loading. Hard stare is loading. It's with intent to harm. That's what loading is. No bonk. Next.
Tiffany, Amazon is still shipping the mini educators and fast.
Nice.
Good to know.
Nice. To buy them.
Yeah.
They're going to run out and they can't get any more.
Nope. Tessa, hi.
Well, hold on. Sorry. They can't get any more for about a month. Rephrase that.
Hi, your videos have helped me to feel like I don't have to put down another dog for aggression, even though my dog just gave me the worst bite.
Well, there's always hope, and then there's always the hard decision, and there's always a level of acceptance, and then there's always safety to think about. So, community safety, your safety, your guest safety, Make sure you muzzle condition that dog, though. Get that dog very comfortable in a Baskerville muzzle. Next.
Denicia, how many reps to train Jupiter, my 8-month-old puppy, to stay in place in the crate?
One more time.
How many reps to train my 8-month puppy to stay in place in the crate?
I don't know. You tell me. Practice this week and let me know on Monday. All right? Next. I'm not being a cocky son of a bitch. I don't know. I have no idea how many reps it would take your dog. I don't know your skill set. I don't know your dog. I don't know how much time you're going to spend on it. You tell me. Next.
David, should my puppy be meeting people on a walk, or should I be teaching her to ignore and keep walking?
We teach dogs to ignore all environmentals. Now, that doesn't make them antisocial. We have very social dogs, put it this way: the most leash reactive dog that I ever worked with, the most leash reactive dog was a 90 to 100-pound Rottweiler. When it saw a dog, this dog pulled its owner across the freaking street. It reared up on its hind legs. This dog went to doggy daycare every day. Never got into a dog fight. So it just wanted to play. It literally wanted to play. It doesn't matter. Walk next to me. Heel is heel. Next.
Jasmine, hey guys. So my dog likes to run up to me and shove a toy in my face when I sit down. He loves fetch a lot. Super annoying. I put him on place, but the situation repeats itself every night. Any suggestions?
Right, because you're not correcting it. You're giving him an obedience command. Teach him the out command. I've got a video on out, meaning get the Frank Sinatra out of here. All right? Teach that. I got a free video on that. It's on YouTube. Next.
Tiffany, pup badly reacts to bonking, redirects aggressively. Alternatives?
Yeah, put a dominant dog collar on that dog and teach it not to do that. Redirection is a choice. You just revealed your dog. So in other words, a lot of people think, oh, bonking makes the dog aggressive. No, it doesn't. Also, I don't know your timing. So make sure your timing is the first sign of loading, not when the dog's already in drive. If you do when the dog's in drive, you're going to take that energy and they are going to redirect it. But some dogs do go into defense. We've got a dog here that doesn't give a shit about 99% of the corrections we give it. Okay? It goes into defense. It literally, we get dogs that'll go, that's all you got?
Yeah.
That's all you got.
Yeah.
They're like, keep it coming. I'm gonna keep fighting you. I'm gonna keep fighting you. And it's not pit bulls. It's not, you know, this one's a Chihuahua mix. You know what I mean? So it's like we have dogs that will tell you to F off until the day they die.
Yep.
And they'll do it with their teeth because they don't care. So what you want to do is but redirection is a choice. The dog did not have to redirect on you. So you have to teach the dog that redirection is a wrong choice. So again, muzzle condition the dog, put a muzzle on that dog, and be able to, as soon as that dog tries to redirect or does redirect, you're going to have to dominant dog collar, you're going to hold the dog up in the air, you're not helicoptering the dog, you're not hanging the dog, okay? Look up dominant dog collars on Learberg's website, all right? But you're like, you're not going to bite me. That's not acceptable. It's a choice. Next.
Jasmine, I just wanted to mention that my relationship with my dogs has improved so much since watching your videos religiously. Thank you so much, truly.
Awesome. Thank you. Yes. I only talk about things that I know about. I only talk about things that work. I only talk about things that we've done anywhere from 100 to 10,000 times. I've been trained a lot of dogs. And I get a ton of feedback from social media. I travel the world doing seminars. This is not an ego statement. So when I give out advice, historically, it works. There's always outliers. There's always going to be outliers out there, like we mentioned earlier. But a lot of it boils down to, believe it or not, no matter what you're how you train a dog, structure. That's the most important thing. Mm. Structure and make your dog work for stuff. And don't treat training like a game. Treat it like a lifestyle. Next.
True story. Denicia, what age do you start e-collars?
You can start a dog on an e-collar. Depends on your skill set. At 14 weeks old, but you're not using it to correct a dog. You're just teaching the dog what that pressure is. Pressure is everything. You walk towards your dog, that's pressure. Mm-hmm. You pull the leash, that's pressure. The dog pulls on the leash, that's pressure. Everything is pressure. All a remote collar is pressure, but you're not using it to correct at all. And what you're doing is you're doing it to overlap your existing food training, and you will keep doing food training. Next.
Tessa, we are getting another Baskerville.
Nice.
Sophia, since I introduced the e-collar to Bruno yesterday and today, when we passed other dogs on the walk today, I tapped a couple times on his working level. Is that okay at this time?
I don't know. Did it work or not? You tell me. Did it work or did it not? Usually, if the dog's already aroused, working level goes up. Don't be stuck on a number, Tessa. Is that Tessa that said that?
Yeah, I think she's overlapping obedience and behavior mod like a lot of people do. Like, if you're conditioning the dog for obedience, you want to be in, like, lower levels. Yeah.
Right.
But if your dog's leash reactive, you can stop with a higher level.
Right, exactly. Remember, levels fluctuate. The dog tells you what level to use. So, is it right? You tell me. Did it work? If it didn't work, it's not right. If it worked, it's right. Next. The dog has the answers.
Eric, I love how blunt Jeff is. No sugarcoating, and that's what many owners need.
Yeah. That's what many dogs need. I'm not trying to sound smart. I'm being practical. Life is too short. People are struggling. People are struggling. Life is too short, and I don't need to impress anybody with how smart I am. I'm trying to get you results. That's all that I give a shit about, is your success, not about how I look. All right, next.
Jasmine, we'll look up the out command video. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Jenny, how do you reintroduce dogs that have been in a fight? Our friend's dog attacked our dog when he was younger. We want to get them to coexist. No expectation for them to play. What should we do?
Okay, too many variables, too risky to give advice like this. That's why I'm going to start doing my Patreon sort of like a hangout. So I can ask you back and forth. We can go back and forth. First thing I would do is make sure both those dogs are muzzled up, and then go on mutual walks together, do place together, do down together. Don't get them, no high-pitched voices, no food, no resources. And a human is a resource. Be ready to correct high. Have a third person there for safety. And again, get them to exist and go slow. And when things are working out, don't push it. The reason why they're working out is because you didn't push it. Okay? So every time Uncle Joe comes in the house, the dog runs to the door and bites him. Great. You correct the dog for that. Teach the dog place. Now Uncle Joe can come in. The dog doesn't move. Uncle Joe gets up and goes, oh, the dog's behaving nicely. I think I'm going to go over and pet the dog. Dog bites Uncle Joe. Mm-hmm. What the fuck? I've been here for half an hour. Dog didn't race at me. That's because you left the dog alone. And I advocated for the dog. I told the dog that rushing the door sucks. Stop the bad behavior. I trained a better, what I really wanted, which was go to place. Mm-hmm. And mind your own damn business. So Uncle Joe can come in and sit down. Mm-hmm. Now Uncle Joe's got to get up and go over and pet the damn dog.
Uncle Joe needs to respect the dog.
Okay. Next.
Tiffany said thank you.
You're welcome.
Jasmine, thank you for what you do. You're awesome.
You're welcome. My staff does even more, though. You see what my staff does.
You're welcome.
No, I mean, I'm like, thank you.
Flustered.
Yeah, but you should see my staff. Next.
Barista boy, have you ever had a dog that could not be trained?
No, but I've had dogs that I could not get up to a level of expectation that I thought was acceptable to be safe in this world. Next.
Brother Daggett, do you have any videos on resource guarding? For a while, I've noticed that my dog has had some resource guarding issues.
Yes, the out command as well. You can use the out command for that as well. Next.
I just got bummed.
What happened? What does it do? Have a mind of its own?
Judgment. I saw a pic of you when you were younger. Same hair. Love it.
Oh, thanks. How much younger?
It was probably the picture of you and...
Oh, Clover.
Clover. Yeah, you've had that hair a long time.
That's Clover's 15. So it was 15 years ago.
Did you ever have short hair? Did you come out of the womb like that? He just comes out with a ponytail.
Damn! That's why you're in there for an extra week. Growing some hair. I was a towhead. I had white hair.
Really?
Yeah. Yep. I had white blonde
you
hair.
You like don't even have the complexion to be a towhead.
I was a towhead.
You're not like really pale. I had a towhead
in my, and I had a cage.
Your eyes aren't like super blue.
And I had a Jamaican accent.
Did you?
Yeah.
How did you have a Jamaican accent?
Ask my mom.
Shut up.
Swear, ask her.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, swear to God.
You're lying.
No. I mean, not every word, but I would like, yeah.
How?
I don't know how.
Did you have like a Jamaican nanny or something?
I don't think so.
What the
fuck? I don't know. Next.
What the fuck? Jamaican accent. Alrighty then. Ken, do you think leaving a dog in a fenced-in backyard for 20 to 60 minutes unsupervised is a bad routine? She has whining issues with squirrels, birds, and other things. Should I do long-duration stays outside?
You can do long-duration sits. You can do sitting in a chair outside, downing, place, unsupervised. I'm not a big fan of dogs being anywhere but in a crate unsupervised. A lot of variables there. But, I mean, I've got a dog that lives outside back home. You know, I don't supervise him.
He was cracking me up today.
You know, he lives outside.
Mac.
Yeah, Mac. We went over to the house today to do, don't worry, we did proper social distancing. We needed Angelo, though, to do some scooter stuff. Angelo misses it here. He wants his old routine back.
Yeah, we miss Angelo.
I know. He'll be back soon enough.
It's not the same.
No. Nothing's the same.
Mm-mm.
Nothing.
No, it's like, I just realized that, like, our lunch breaks are so quiet because normally Angelo's like, and today right. I beat this boss on Pokemon.
I have not heard anybody talk about a video game here for for a while.
I know.
It'll all happen again. Yeah. I put up a video. Did I put that video that I showed you? Did I put that up? Yeah, I put that on this page, I think.
Oh, did you?
I think so. Yeah. Next.
Yesenia, hi J&J, hope you guys are well. Question, can you do a video on resource guarding dogs with dogs? Not sure on how to do the out command when there's multiple dogs in the home.
Well, I don't do custom videos, but there's an out video that you can use that means get the F out of here. So you can do that. But also, there's a lot of variables with resource guarding dogs because that ends up turning into a dog fight. That's why, again, I'm doing this Patreon thing again, because now we can have a conversation like face to face. I've got 20 questions to ask you, but you can also do a Skype with me.
Mm-hmm.
That's the magic of Skype. Like, there's so many variables in dog training when it comes to certain things, but it would be almost unethical for me to be like, you've got multiple dogs in the house with resource guarding. Well, and if they're resource guarding each other, that means you have to have at least two dogs out. Well, shit could hit the fan if I give you the wrong information. But if we speak, I can give you very detailed information. Next.
Holding on dog training. Small dog who hasn't been able to pet for 6 years, taking equipment off is a trigger. Got past that kind of, but I'm hearing a very, very faint growl as he enters the crate, which is better than the start. Suggestions?
He's just telling you probably fuck off, Ashley. He's like, yeah, I'll go in the crate. Fuck you.
6 years, it's a lot of pattern behavior, though.
Yeah, that's the thing. When you get these... So, is an older dog harder to train than a younger dog? Not necessarily. But if an older dog has had 5 years of pattern behavior, we have some dogs that stop right away. Literally, one correction. Oh, why didn't you tell me?
Yeah.
Nobody ever told me that. We've got other dogs that are like, listen here, son. I've been doing this for a long time.
Literally, if they could talk.
I ain't stopping for
no... Listen here.
Listen here, son. Mm-hmm. Listen here, son. I've been doing this for a long time.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't give a shit.
I said, I don't care about you. I don't care about your mama. I don't care about nobody or nothing. Because I'm in this for myself. Now,
so true.
You fetch me some food, young man, and you get it here quick.
And don't talk to me.
That's right. And don't talk to me.
Yeah. It's just going to take time, Ashley.
Ashley, you made a huge progress. Don't be so hard on yourself, because that's what you do. I know it. I know it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what you're doing right now? You just said, you're right, Jeff. I am hard on myself. I can picture you right there, right now. And I bet you your husband's already told you that. Next.
Jasmine, LOL, did you solve the ticking in that room you were staying in?
Yeah, ripped the whole fucking thing out of the wall.
How did you fix that?
I ripped it out of the fucking wall.
Did you really?
Well, I had Harold remove it. Oh. I said, Harold, Harold is, he's a retired electrician. He lives on the property. I give him a room. And he doesn't speak any English. And I said, so I have to text him because he puts it through a translator. I'm like, TikTok, TikTok, TikTok. And he doesn't go onto the app. He ain't fucking like looking at my latest TikTok videos. Okay. And he like comes downstairs. He goes, so I told him, I said, I want an on off switch. I got to go turn the lights on now. It's an electric timer for an automatic timer for our outside parking lot lights. Our outside parking lot lights up like daytime. So, but when you're not in the room, you don't hear it. But I'm living literally in a room 10 feet in front of me right now. I've got my own private, I guess you can call that a bedroom. There's a bed in it, and it's a room, so it's a bedroom. And that's what the timer is. And it's like, tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock.
That shit would drive me crazy.
And I'm like, fuck this. So after the second or third night, I forgot what it was, I'm like, Harold, get rid of the tick-tock. So he puts, I said, on, off, on, off, on, off. I'll turn them on, I'll turn them off. And so he puts the switch in.
And he's like, the clap on. Clap on.
And he goes, okay, 1.5 hours, TikTok will stop. Guess what?
TikTok didn't stop.
TikTok didn't stop. Didn't fucking stop. Okay?
TikTok.
And I'm like, I said, TikTok, gone. Disconnect, gone. Remove. So he removed the whole automatic timing system. And now I just have a switch on and off. And as soon as I get out of there, we want it to be on automatic because then you can forget about it. You know, it's a really nice one. You can set the time of when you want it off, days of the week, all that stuff, programmable. Next.
Man, this keeps bumping me.
Wow.
All right. Jamie, how long can a 10-month-old husky go before bathroom breaks?
10-month-old? I mean, it should sleep through the night. So what's that, 8 hours, 10 hours? Next.
Jenny, thank you so much. All the content you shared have helped us tremendously. We have a lot of structure. Our now 14-month-old dog, Atlas, is doing much better with heel, leash reactivity, separation, and anxiety.
One more time.
Thank you so much.
Yep, got it.
All the content you shared.
Okay. Fix that to fix it all, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, I thought you already had a question on how to fix it. Good. So number one, code word for you've been busting your ass. Because anxiety, that's a rough one.
That is.
It's funny because when I mentor a lot of young dog trainers, not just young, but like new dog trainers and actually experienced dog trainers. I'm getting an easy dog and it's got separation anxiety. I'm like, really? I'd rather work with a biting dog sometimes.
Me too. Me too.
I'd rather work with a biting dog.
Give me all the aggression.
Yep. So, we got a thumbs down. Nice. Aww. Thank you. Still hating. Priorities, guys. It's a good time to reframe yourself. You can still hate me if you want to. But just think about that. It's a good time to share some love.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are struggling right now.
A lot of people are struggling.
It's a good time to like self-evaluate.
Yeah.
And like try to be positive.
It's a really
and,
good
like,
time.
Spread some love.
Yep. It's hard though because people don't know.
Yeah.
They don't know how to.
Right.
They don't know how to.
It's a lot of work to like actually work on yourself.
It's a lot of work and it's scary as fuck. Mm-hmm. Right now is a really hard time for a lot of people.
Yeah.
It's a really hard time for a lot of people. A lot of your extroverts out there, guys. So a lot of your introverts, they're doing possibly better than your extroverts. Your extroverts are possibly struggling the most right now. So you've got some happy-go-lucky friend that's like, oh my God, they're always positive, they're always this. You want to check in on them.
Mm-hmm.
You want to check in on them.
Check in on your strong, happy friends, okay? For sure.
Because guess what? They might be the one. It's the ones that are like, stay at home every night. You know, they're always reading a book. You know, they're fine not going out. Like, they're probably, I don't want to say they're doing okay too. I mean, everybody is struggling. But they might be having an easier time. But it's the one that can't get out of their own way sometimes that's really struggling. Next.
Barista boy, tried sitting in a chair. Dog seemed pretty tired afterward. Definitely looked focused and concentrating while sitting and just doing nothing. Thank you, guys.
Excellent. Good job, barista boy. If anybody wants to know what he's talking about, sitting in chair. Did we put a video up on that? A how-to?
Yeah.
We did, yeah. Mm-hmm. We did a live on that, too.
DIY 2020.
Yes, spaghetti.
Melissa posted the link to Skype with you.
Thank you.
Andrew, Hey guys, haven't been around for a bit. Had to get my shit together. Miss Pearson, but hopefully next time. Anyway, just want to say hello and missed your faces.
Oh, well, thanks for joining. You know what, though? We're always getting our shit together. Every day I'm getting my shit together.
Every day is a good day to get your shit together.
Every day. You got to work on this stuff every day. Next.
Yeah. Coach Harden, walking both my dogs while listening to the live. Happy to be here.
Awesome. Awesome.
Sabrina, every time Frozone is left to his own devices, his behavior deteriorates in small increments. All of a sudden, it's noticeable.
Yep, that's what it is. A little bit. How did I gain 20 pounds? Well, I haven't seen you in 10 years. 2 pounds a year. There's your 20 pounds. So, yep, every little bit. And then there's stacking.
Yeah.
Stacking. Now's a good time for everybody to be stacking good habits. Next.
Brother Daggett, OMG, Jeff, you're funny, LOL.
Oh, well, thank you.
David, Jeff, how did you get into training dogs, and why did you decide to make it a career?
I got into training dogs by having a dog just like a lot of you. I got it as a puppy, didn't know what the fuck I was doing. He was human aggressive, dog aggressive, redirected on me. Nobody could help me. People told me to put him down. Went through all these trainers. Finally, someone helped me, and I was like, holy shit, you changed my life. And then a woman saw me out in public. And that's back when I used to own a sex shop. Look me up, Miko Exotic Wear. It ain't no secret, folks. Okay? Okay? I was around for 15 years. Best place for sexy gifts. 15 years in a row. It ain't no secret.
Best place for okay? sexy gifts.
I was the largest importer of silicone sex toys. In fact, I brought them into the U.S. out of Germany. So what I want you to do is... I said to myself, you know what? I was burnt out from that business. I love helping people. Everyone thinks it's this dog-loving thing. It's a people-loving thing. I love people. Dogs are my Trojan horse. That doesn't mean I don't like dogs. You can have both, okay? But I love helping people. So I don't want to say I'm using dogs. Oh, Jeff uses dogs. It's like, you know, fucking soundbite galore out of this, right? So dogs are my Trojan horse to get people's lives to be better. Next.
Josue, hi guys. Thank you for the workouts on IG.
Oh, you're welcome.
You're welcome.
That would be Joelle.
Hopefully they're helpful to you.
Yep.
Andrew, PS, since I found you guys, you've helped give me the confidence to work with the dog I brought into my rescue and to your seminar. She's alive and a new dog.
Nice. That's awesome. Proud of you.
Kristen, hey guys, have a 10-week-old dog de Bordeaux pup. I hope I didn't just botch that.
It's okay. It's a big ass fucking dog.
That is horrible for ankle biting, chasing, nipping. We are redirecting.
Yep.
But can we bonk for this behavior? Damn right. Other suggestions?
Yes. No bonk. Cut that shit out now. The dog doesn't grow out of it. The dog grows into it. Let that dog know, you know what? It's Saturday night. We're stopping that. If the dog's already in bed tomorrow morning, guess what? I'm going to be having my bagel with my smoked salmon, letting you know that that's not acceptable. So I got a bagel in my left hand, a bonker in my right hand, and no bonk. No more ankle biting. Take a bite.
Lox bagel. $4.99 top chat from Ashley. Haha, you know me. Thank you. Dave is doing the victory dance. He was right. At least we are petting the dog now, so it's progress.
Yeah, we know you. Tell Dave we said hi. We love you, buddy. Miss you.
Let's see. Michelle P. Hi, guys. Just jumping on. Hey, Michelle. Hope you're feeling better.
Hope you're feeling better.
I still have hives all over me. I don't know what I ate that I was allergic to, but my whole body's covered in hives.
Your food, is it the new supplement you're taking, maybe?
Maybe.
Ooh.
I fucking hope.
Oh, yep. We'll talk about that afterwards.
Andrew, people need structure just as much as dogs need structure during this time.
People need a lot. You need a routine.
Yes, you do, guys.
So I'm up at, you don't want to know what time I get up at, early. And every morning I'm working. I took a rest day last week. But we built.
A rest day. Just one.
Excuse me, ma'am. How many rest days do you take a week?
Usually two, actually.
No, you do not.
Yeah.
Oh, no, you do not. You can't take any. Okay, you get all crazy.
I do get crazy.
You get all Joelle crazy. So that's a whole other level kind of crazy.
Need my exercise.
So, but we built a gym here.
Yep.
We built a gym here.
It's awesome. I don't think I'll ever go back to a normal gym.
Yep. Next.
Sabrina, everyone, don't forget to give Jeff some thumbs up.
Don't worry about it, but thank you.
Jamie, don't worry about the haters. You're doing so much good.
Guys, I can give a flying fuck about haters. Never have, never will. And after this whole corona thing, it's like, you know what? If you want to fucking hate, you just keep hating. Okay? You just really, people are dying in the streets. I still get hate mail. I still get hate comments. Mm-hmm. And it's like, you know what? That's really too bad. It's really, really too bad.
Yeah.
It's too bad that people have to do that. With so many people out there, so many people need help right now.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to fucking hate on me. So many people need help. Your next door neighbor needs help.
Yeah.
Like, people can't buy groceries. People right. are out of work. Like, people are freaking, are going crazy out there. And you got to sit at your fucking keyboard and put out hate. That makes you like lower than scum. When things were good, the economy was great, everything was plugging along, people were running around, that's a good time to hate me. But now, you should be hating anybody.
No.
Because hate is not going to fix this shit.
There's already so much hate.
This should be the biggest reset in your life.
True that.
This should be the biggest reset in your life. And if you're hating now, man, you just revealed yourself. I got an interesting hate. I hate email, which is really stupid. They filled out one of my forms, which is just like, you know, I got your IP address now, you know? But it's like, really? You had to do that? I hope this puts you out of business. Son, this ain't putting me out of business. Trust me on that one. We're going to be the ones that are in business. Next.
Steven, love your content. When should I wash my puppy for the first time?
Anytime you want. Next.
Anytime you want. Start earlier. Make them love the water, that's for sure.
Yep.
Yesenia, thank you, Melissa, for the info.
Thank you, Melissa.
Barista boy. Also, thank you, Joelle and staff that I don't see 2 to 3 times a week.
You should see them a lot, though, because they're in their videos on the all feed the time. Daily. Yeah, they're on the feed. They're on Instagram. Make sure you check us out on Instagram.
I have a great one going up tomorrow. Ben acting his usual Ben ways, distracting dogs.
But Instagram stories, there's always great stuff up there.
Yeah. Did you see the TikTok I made of Ben? Like, with his little baby shopping cart, and he's, like, pretending to, like, put shit
did
in
you?
It.
Did you put it on our TikTok channel?
It was on stories.
Did you? Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice.
Let's see. Salvador, do you teach every dog to double down?
Yes, we do.
Sure do.
It's a great way for mental. It's not just physical down, it's mental down. Next.
Michelle P., there's a new toy that's really awesome. I just can't get past the name of it. It's called Tracy's Dog. It's such a good toy, though. What the hell is it? What is it? Tracy's Dog.
What does it do? You pull its tail and it shits? Next. Because they got that toy. You've seen that before?
No.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah. It's a kid's toy. It's like for Barbie and shit.
Marta. Hey, guys. Miss you, too.
Oh, hey, Marta. How are you, honey?
Is this like Marta?
Yeah, that's Marta. Yeah.
Oh, hey, Marta.
Yeah, that's Marta. Oh. She's got 5 names.
I haven't seen her like on the podcast, I don't think, ever.
Ever. I know. Hey, Marta. She's stalking us. She's stealing ideas for Sean.
Andrew. Oh, it's Jen, not Andrew. LOL. Oh, hi, Jen.
Hey, Jen.
Jamie, YouTube newbie here. First live.
Oh, awesome.
Welcome.
Welcome, Jamie.
Sabrina, I found out last year that I don't produce any immunoglobulins.
Globulins, yep.
I'm used to being home and having learned to really enjoy myself. LOL.
Awesome.
Brother Daggett, I'm on the treadmill listening to you guys.
Brother Daggett.
Nice.
Good job. Mm-hmm. Good. Hey, if you're going to be on the treadmill, you better.
Might as well be listening to us.
You better be listening to something.
Something.
Some audiobook. Or watch a video. If you're sitting on your couch watching Netflix, get on the fucking treadmill and watch Netflix.
True that.
They got a little tray there, you know. That tray is for something.
I knew it. I was thinking that because it's Michelle P. and she's our most scandalous YouTube watcher. Oh my God, Tracy's dog is a toy for women. That's what I was thinking. I'm like, did she mean a sex toy?
Oh, sex toy. Nice.
Interesting.
It's like the rabbit.
Maybe. Sabrina, I read. Brother Daggett, I read. Amy, I just found you. Should I bonk when loading, even if he doesn't always react, just sometimes?
Yes.
Sometimes he controls it.
That's when you bonk. So it's no, watch my video. No, and then bonk. Loading leads to bad stuff. If you know what loading is, it's this. Hey, man, check out the scenery. Hey, what's up? I'm going to fuck you up.
Literally.
That's when you go, no, bonk. Remember? I'm not going around bonking dogs randomly. Like, you're doing something to get bonked. Next.
Cheryl, shut down solid canine group came up as a suggestion on Facebook. I was like, why would I ever want to join that? I'm for trainers supporting other trainers, yeah. Not hating each other. Trust Algorithm's me. Gone wrong.
Yep, there's tons of those. There's petitions, there's tons of them. It's like, whatever, guys. Get a life. Next.
Andrew and Jen referred my neighbors to you. FYI, they have two labs and need help.
Okay, start them on the free videos first. They might be able to fix a problem for nothing. If not, we move them over to a Skype. If not, we can always do more. But tell them to at least use the free content. Next.
Barista Boy said, yes, you're right. I do love the social media content. So helpful to see the advice here put into action on Instagram, Twitter.
Yep. We practice what we preach. We're real dog trainers doing real work, doing real rehab in real time.
Really, really.
Really, really.
Really, really.
Well, we're done for the day, except for last call.
It's 7:59.
But one more question.
It's Marta. Hey, hey, hey. I try to hop on a live whenever I can.
Which is never Marta. Which is
okay,
never.
We still love you, Marta.
We still love you, Marta. All right? Sean's probably not giving you any attention tonight.
Getting a fucking football for that.
So like, you owe me
leave
two.
Marta alone.
You owe me two more. There you go. Ow.
You can hang out with us, Marta.
You can hang out with us, Marta. We love you. We probably love you. We love you more anyway. I'm Marta's first true love. You know that, right? Marta was she was a super fan of mine, and she knew that I was already taken, so she jumped over to Sean.
And on that note,
it's
time to go.
We are madly in love with you. We cannot wait to see you. Remember, 7 to 8 now. It's a 60-minute show every Monday, Wednesday, and starting next week, Friday. Which is going to work out with our travel schedule really well. Mm-hmm. The last thing we want to do after the first day of a fucking seminar is do a show.
Yeah.
But Friday night before the show, it's way easier. It actually might be actually good for us to do it mm-hmm. mentally.
Right.
So we'll see you soon. All right.
We'll see you soon.
Love you. But don't forget, we're doing lives all the time. Our Instagram live, Facebook live. We've got tomorrow we're filming a new separation anxiety video. We've got about 6 good pieces of content to put up tomorrow.
I edited the dogs in the woods today.
Oh, did you really? Over the log?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Excellent. And don't forget, cool dog tricks. You want to do something fun with your dog? Cool, C-O-O-L, dog, D-O-G, tricks. CoolDogTricks.com. Hit the penny option so you get twice as many tricks. Type in girl, G-I-R-L, cool dog tricks, penny option, girl, 25% off. Teach your dog some tricks. All right?
There you go.
Madly in love with all of you. Can't wait to see you again. Thank you all. Bye-bye.
Good night.